That's not good.
In my MacBook Pro 2015 video, I lamented that I had to carry a dedicated charger just for my laptop. And a reader told me about something I had never ever considered looking for. A USB-C to MagSafe 2 adapter. If these just simply worked, I wouldn't have much of a video, maybe something only worthy of a YouTube short. But clearly they don't work out because there's this video right here, right? Well, the two products I bought to test are the APEXSUN Magnetic L-Tip USB-C MagSafe 1 adapter and the USB-C to Magnetic T-Tip charging cable by OUGIC, I think that's how you say it, which is MagSafe 2. Both of these products are from the Chinese e-waste gray market on Amazon. For my testing, I have three Macs, a MacBook Pro 2012, aka MagSafe 1, a MacBook Air 2015, and a MacBook Pro 2015, both of which are MagSafe 2. For my USB-C chargers to test against, I have an Apple 30-watt charger, a Ugreen 140-watt Nexode GaN charger, and a Apple 96-watt charger. Let's start with the MagSafe 1 adapter, which is a simple dongle that you can attach to any USB-C cable. My first impression is that it's the perfect size to easily get lost. When I plugged it into the MacBook Pro 2012, before I even got to testing it, it immediately fell apart. The first time I disconnected it, the magnetic portion that secures the MagSafe detached, which required me to grab a pair of pliers so I could pull the magnetic bit off my Mac. It's not even worth testing as this is an absolute piece of junk. The APEXSUN Magnetic L-Tip is trash and no one should buy it. In fact, this thing might even be a fire hazard. Check this out. Those are 100% real sparks.
If you look at the Amazon reviews, I'm not the only person who experienced this problem. This product is legit a danger. I mean, you saw the sparks. Those were real.
This made me worried about my next product, but the USB-C magnetic T-tip charging cable looks and feels like a higher quality product. It has a reinforced cable neck and base. While I wouldn't call this rugged, it does seem up to the task of being a laptop power cable. It looks very similar to Apple's MagSafe 3 cables used on modern MacBook Pros and functions nearly the same with the orange LED light to indicate charging. The cable lists itself as a 60-watt power cable, and I was curious about these claims because I have some questions about USB power negotiation. We'll get to that. My first test was with a 140-watt Ugreen Nexode with a kilowatt electrical usage monitor with a AVHZY CT3 multimeter. I apologize as the TFT screen on the AVHZY is a tough thing to capture. The kilowatt reports 75 watts and the CT3 reports 67. The discrepancy is largely caused by the gallium nitride charger, which is far from 100% efficient, with a fraction of the power loss being attributed to things like cable losses and the consumption of the CT3. This was very similar to the Apple 96-watt power supply, which was drawing 74 from the wall and outputting 67. So far, there haven't been any surprises. The cable didn't get hot or catch fire. Now, the 30-watt charger is where things get interesting, but in order to understand why, we have to get geeky. USB has had power profiles for ages, with the power delivery protocol, where roles are defined like which is the source, aka the charger, and which is the sink, the one receiving the power. When a USB device is plugged in, there's a discovery process that lists the power profiles, which are combinations of voltage and current, which both devices support and thus negotiate.
They find a setting that works for both of them.
USB PD 3.0 adds in granularity like continuous dynamic voltage and current negotiation within certain ranges. This is fundamental for quick charge technologies. On the Amazon page, it's listed as 60 watts, so I was very curious what would happen if I plugged into a 30-watt charger. This probably shouldn't come as a surprise, but it doesn't work with the 30-watt power supply. Whereas with a USB-C Mac, you can trickle charge even a 16-inch MacBook Pro. This is because MagSafe 3 uses the USB PD protocol. I strongly suspect the OUGIC MagSafe cable does the power negotiation and not the MacBook, thus a 30-watt charger fails to negotiate. You can actually observe this cycle by watching the MacBook Pro's display pulse. The MacBook Pro sees the charger and then changes the brightness momentarily but goes back to the battery settings.
I do feel confident in recommending this cable,
But the caveat is you need at least a 60-watt charger. It is a lot more convenient than carrying around one of these guys, especially if you already have a USB-C charger and you use it for other things. Otherwise, I don't know, I'd probably stick with the Apple one